We can talk. Let this lady go.
I can't. I can't go back.
Reichert continued moving backward with the poodle yipping at his ankles, distracting him, when Psyche lunged at him with rocket force, taking him and the woman down, slamming him hard to the ground and sending the knife flying, rolling him to his stomach and handcuffing him. Bonar comforted the woman, who was bleeding, crying, and holding her poodle as it licked her face. Paramedics were called, and two patrol cars arrived, sirens, wailing, lights, wig-wagging. Motel guests were watching the scene from the ground and the upper deck. When Psyche read Reichert his rights, he began mumbling.
It's so messed up. I just wanted to be her friend.
31. Nevada. Grace Jarrett struggled to pay attention. Silver Sky Search and Rescue Incident Commander Warren Taylor was briefing the volunteers at the group's command post in the Sagebrush parking lot. Upward of 60 women and men of all ages, wearing fluorescent orange vests, t-shirts, hats, and backpacks with radios clipped to the straps, had stopped their lives, left their jobs, to rush down here and help in the search for Riley. Grace stood among them with John and Blake. She was dressed in donated sweatpants and a t-shirt with Nevada arched across it, and fighting to concentrate on what Taylor was saying. But all she could think of was the detective showing them photos of a strange man who may know something about Riley, and then that poor girl murdered nearby last year. It was all too much. Am I losing my hold on reality? Wandering and collapsing in the desert last night, and now I can't stop fearing Riley was taken by a stranger. Grace struggled to focus on the search, but she'd lost track of time. It was 20 minutes or over an hour since McDowell and Elson had asked her about the strange man, saying they had no evidence Riley had been hurt. How could they be sure? Seeing those photos of the man had shaken her, and she was still reeling. Now, Grace battled to grasp what Taylor was telling the group about the next stage of the search as he pointed to a large map affixed to the side of the command vehicle.
We're liaising with Metro Missing Persons. We'll deploy teams to scout prime areas,
he said.
We'll assign others to work with Silver Sagebrush Security to again comb the facility and search surrounding areas.
He moved on to technical aspects, making a 360-degree circle with his hand over the map, taking into account Riley's height, weight, her condition, estimating a pace of 3 to 5 miles an hour in any direction.
We've calculated these search parameters, which should put us in close proximity of where Riley could be.
He paused as a police helicopter passed overhead, then said,
As the sun climbs, we're looking at desert temps of up to 110, 115. She could be dehydrated. There are snakes, coyotes, mountain lions, a lot of factors.
He pointed to the distant west side of the interstate, noting some searchers would be transported to search areas there.
We'll never quit searching until we find her.
Taylor, a retired U.S. Marine major, told the group, concluding by directing people to line up to receive assignments and form teams. Grace looked at John.